and go up there.
So the risk is very high, and obviously, as a result of the high risk, you do have close encounters.
It's too dangerous for Craig to dive alone. He'll be taking two colleagues as lookouts.
But has Craig misjudged how aggressive the Great White is? Before he's even gotten into the water, the shark takes a bite at his fin.
I'm going to the water, and I see how I feel with the shark down there. The shark may change behavior completely once I hit the water.
Hello, man.
Then my heart can pump in, and the shark's off 5 feet, and I realize what the risk is, and I stay close to the boat.
If anything goes wrong, a single pulp is all the team will have to defend themselves.
Look at the sharky right there. Look at the mouth. It's right there. He got
this
you.
This is a 16-foot, fully grown female. She's an intelligent hunter and picks her prey carefully. By being reckless or too timid. At first she's wary, circling, checking the team out. This is all part of the ritual. Slowly she starts to edge closer, and suddenly her behavior dramatically changes. As the great white approaches, her pectoral fins drop into the attack position. Craig knows he must not panic, or the shark will attack.
When you're in the water with a white shark, and the salmon's coming at you, you can't leave the water, you know, immediately. And that's
Not the engine.
You can't go in the engine.
Yeah, you can't go in the engine. It's a pretty big engine, isn't it?
Appreciate you almost saying all work. All right.
on his shoulder.
It's still raining out there?
Nah.
Just hot and humid. We're getting good reactions from the crowds today.
I'm still on here.
44th year anniversary.
Bumper! Yeah. So
I've been using it in the speeches and they always clap.
Bumper, I'm still on here.
All right, let's go down.
I'm still here.
Come on, let's go.